Imagine putting on a blindfold and entering a shopping market to grab something basic like bread. While you move through the store, every product you pass jumps up and down and loudly proclaims what it is. Product, hot sauce. Product, zucchini. Product, toaster strudels. While these proclamations technically make each of the products more accessible to you, they start to overwhelm you because each time you hear the word product, you have to pause a moment and listen to see if it's bread. Every page element that screen reader users encounter announces itself, just like the products in the hypothetical grocery store. Header, XYZ, button, XYZ, etc. Screen reader users can't visually scan pages to quickly determine what's relevant and what's not. They have to listen carefully and deal with everything individually. Now, alternative text or alt text is a description of an image in the code that allows a screen reader user to understand the image's message. It's easy to just say that every image should have comprehensive alt text because it technically makes them all more accessible. The thing is, this blanket approach kind of neglects thinking about the overall usability of a page. When we add alt text to images, we include them among the many page elements screen reader users have to grapple with. It focuses on accessibility in a vacuum. Sighted users' eyes are immediately drawn to imagery, but that's not the case for screen reader users. For them, images have no special appeal. Since they're already sifting through so much information, they only want to deal with images that contribute task-related information that isn't going to slow them down. Leaving alt attributes empty causes screen readers to skip over them. Now, any accessibility expert will tell you that purely decorative images should be skipped. Functional images that act as links, on the other hand, require alt text to tell users what happens if they click on them. But it's the informative images that get tricky. Informative images that communicate information not captured in the page copy absolutely require alt text because without it, the image's message will be lost. But what about images that communicate information that's already been said elsewhere in the page copy? Sighted users might benefit from getting that information in two modalities, written and visual. But we know that everything is transformed into one modality for screen reader users. Spoken language. Do they really need to hear that same information multiple times just because sighted users benefit from visuals? Focusing on efficiency and usability makes you realize that not every image automatically deserves alt text. You can be more strategic than that because every additional page element is another food item in the grocery store users have to deal with on their way to the bread. Images obviously need to be accessible, but what assistive technology users want most is an easy path to accomplish basic tasks. Check out our article on alt text to think through whether it's useful or redundant for your images.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, innengroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.